Aladdin left kids wanting a magical genie since the early 90s. We're talking about the cartoon version. Since then, it's jumped from the big screen to Broadway and is now in Australia wowing audiences. The magical genie, aka Michael James Scott, he is a standout performance. And as the saying goes, you ain't never had a friend like this. Hey. I have the magic lamp here. I think if I rub it, he might appear. Michael James Scott!
Okay.
Hi! Thank you so much. Thank you. Hi. Hello.
Welcome.
Hi. Yes.
Welcome to the show. Can I just say, Denise has been raving about you for weeks.
You are so brilliant in it. It's one of the most beautiful staged performance, costumes. Yep. Everybody in it just works so hard and so well. It is brilliant.
Wow.
That's all I can say about it.
Well, thank you so much. That's
so
sweet.
And you were fantastic.
Thank you.
Just brilliant. Just brilliant performance.
A subtle role, if you will.
Yeah.
How is it doing the show? Because it is intense. It's full of colour and song and life. You're doing 7 shows a week?
We have 8 shows.
Eight shows a week.
How do you
keep up that energy to constantly, night after night, come out and hit a home run?
A lot of fried chicken. No, I'm sorry. it really is, for me, sleep and water. You know, to be honest with you, it's like the simplest little thing, but it's a marathon. You know, the show is a marathon. And we have a company of amazing people, and we are all kind of just, you know, everyone sort of has to have their routine to sort of get ready and sort of build for it. But for me, I swim too. I love to swim.
Oh.
It's my big warm up, and I warm up in the water as well. Also, I do a lot of trills and things in the water. So
that'd be good for the lungs.
Yes. So, you know, if you're right by me, you might hear like some craziness going on in the water. You might wonder what's going on next door, next to you in the lane.
You're certainly in the right place if you love swimming. Have you been just working nonstop? Have you had a chance to get out and about and see some of Australia? And
a little bit. And now that we're open, I'm finally like getting to really go see places. I have a list of, you know, things to do.
What's number one?
Oh gosh, number one. I think would be to. I actually want to do. I want to go to.
Yes, Rock or Uluru.
Sure.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, I want to go to. Well, I haven't gone to Bondi yet, so I have to definitely go to
Bondi. Oh, swimming! It's like 10 minutes down the river.
I haven't gone like properly down there, but I want to do that. And of course, I want to go climb the bridge, and I want to go to the northern beaches, and you know.
Climb the bridge, you have to do it at twilight because you get the sunset, and then the city lights up with all the lights.
Yes.
After dark, which is
really
it's
a dream to be in Australia. It's a dream come true. I've always
wanted
to.
You're here for 2 years.
I'm here for as long as the show is here. I'm here.
Wow.
So you know,
you might never leave.
I might. You're absolutely right. It's an amazing, amazing country, and it's a dream to be working here. It's always been a bucket list of mine to come here. So to be working here is like, it's beyond. It's just like, I'm pinching myself. I'm like, oh my gosh, I can't believe I'm here.
And getting paid to do it. That's the best thing.
Amen.
Now listen, you've done so many Broadway shows.
Yeah.
Which you did the Mormon?
Book of Mormon.
I was in the original company of Book of Mormon, and I did the revival of Hair. I was in Tarzan, Broadway. I did All Shook Up. I did Mamma Mia.
Wow.
I just finished a show called Something Rotten, which was directed by our director choreographer, Casey Nicola of Aladdin. I did Elf for him on Broadway as well.
Wow.
So,
Elf.
Yeah,
oh,
Elf,
I love
the movie.
Elf.
Yeah, yeah.
I had an Elf puppet.
That's a fun puppet. Yeah.
Where's home for you?
Well, New York City, but I'm a Florida boy. I'm from Orlando, Florida.
Which is the home of Disney, isn't it?
It's such a
magical thing. I think I'm so excited. I've got tickets for the long weekend.
Oh, yeah.
And I've heard you steal the show. But I just can't wait to see it. And I think Disney, it's just all those childhood, isn't it? You've just got a lot to live up to, and it sounds like you're living up to it.
It's such a full circle moment, because I grew up you know, in Orlando and going to Disney and being there. Yeah. And, so to be, I've worked in the, when I was little, I worked in the parks and, you know, So to be able to do it now professionally and, you know, doing it in Australia, and it's just sort of, it's just a full circle moment for me to get
to
do it.
You're on a journey now.
It's a blessing, really, it is.
It is.
Did you do any acting school?
Like, I did.
What did you do?
So I went to uni. Uni. And you also say uni.
Yeah. Very good. Very good.
So I went to uni in St. Louis, Missouri. Went to Webster University Conservatory there, and I also did, I went to performing arts high school as well. Right. So I've been doing this. My mom said I always sang before I spoke.
That was just sunshine on the couch. Oh. You've got this big, beautiful personality.
Thank you.
Can you tell us what it was like when obviously Robin Williams left us not long ago, and he just, you know, he made this role in the movie. What was it like when suddenly you get handed it and say, right, follow that killer? Mm-hmm. What went through your head?
I couldn't really think about the magnitude of it because it's so scary, you know, to step in somebody's shoes like Robin Williams, you know? But what's been so amazing is that the team has allowed me to be me and bring my thing to it. So what's been so cool about that is the foundation of the genie and what, you know, what we all love from the movie and what we know of from the iconic role is there. But I just sort of have Michael on there, and which is really awesome as an actor.
At no stage, and I am the biggest Robin Williams fan, at no stage did I think about Robin Williams when I was watching you. Were just brilliant.
Well, thank you. I mean, you also have to sort of like trust the work that you've done, you know, with the sort of preparing for the role. Yeah. And just go out there, and it's like being shot out of a cannon. You know, you just go, and you don't stop, and you have the best Ainsley, who plays Aladdin. He's so wonderful to play with, and we just have such a fun connection. So it's just a joy to get to do it every night. I mean, I'm a big kid, you know. So for me to tell an audience, you know, more applause, I'm like, okay, sure, I'll do that.
Well, Aladdin is at the Capitol Theatre now. You can head to Ticketmaster for your tickets for this must-see show.